Discuss about parsing. So before we start parsing, initially we need to know what are the types of grammar we have. So you can say there are two types of grammar. Number one is the left recursive grammar, and number two is the right recursive grammar. And when we discuss about parsing, parsing means given some string, or you can say given some line of a program, can you derive that how this program was generated from a given grammar? That is called as parsing. That is why we need to study some basics of grammars here. And the first grammar, I'm telling you, there are two types of grammar. Number one is a left recursive grammar. Second one is a right recursive grammar. In the same way, you can also categorize the grammars as ambiguous grammar and unambiguous grammar. We'll see that. So before that, let us see what is a left recursive grammar. When I'm saying a grammar is a left recursive grammar, that means if all the productions are of the form S derives S alpha slash beta, where alpha comma beta belongs to terminal star, then it is a left recursive grammar. And when I'm saying there's a right recursive grammar, that means if all the productions are of the form S derives alpha S slash beta, where alpha comma beta belongs to T star, then it is called as right recursive grammar. So you can see in the case of left recursive grammar, now this is creating some kind of a recursion. That means S is calling itself in the left side. In the case of right recursive grammar, this is creating recursion and S is calling on the right side. Let me give a very simple example of this. Assuming that we have a grammar something like this, S derives S A slash assuming small b. Okay, and there's a right recursive grammar like this, S derives A S slash small b. Are these two grammars representing the same string or not? Assuming that with this grammar we are trying to generate the strings. So what can the first string S derives B? That means it can generate small b directly, that is a string of length 1. If we try to generate a string of length 2, then can be S derives S A, and this S can be replaced by B, so it is BA. So string of length 2 can be BA. If we try to generate string of length 3, so it can be written as S derives SA, where this S itself can be replaced by SA, so it is SAA, where this S can be replaced by B, so it is BAA, so it is string of length 3. What if we try to generate string of length 4, that can be S derives SA, this S can be further replaced by SAA, this S can be further replaced by SAAA, and this S can be further replaced by B, so it is B triple A, right? So you can see all the strings which we are generating from this particular grammar, they are of the form B A star. That means all the strings which are having exactly one B in the starting. Okay, so this can be represented by this one. Now if you try to generate a string from this right recursive grammar, so let us try to generate a string of length 1, so it can be S derives B, so it is a string of length 1. If we try to generate string of length 2, that can be written as S derives AS, and this S can be replaced by B, so it is AB, that is a string of length 2. If we try to generate string of length 3, that can be S derive AS, this S can be replaced by further AS, then this S can be replaced by B, so AAB, this is a string of length 3. Now if we check what is the language generated by this grammar, that language can be represented by A star B. So you can say this language is a reverse of this language, or you can say both these languages are reverse of each other. So even though the grammars are looking exactly the same, the grammar is looking S derive A S A slash B, and here it is A S slash B. Even though grammars are looking exactly the same, but because of this recursion, because of this position of S, these two grammars are generating exactly two different set of languages. Okay. So that is why you can say a left recursive grammar may not be equivalent to a right recursive grammar. But this left recursive grammar, when we discuss about the compiler design process, or when we discuss about the compilers, this left recursive grammar creates an infinite loop in the program, in parsing process, right? And this doesn't create any problem. The reason is, when we have, in the case of left recursion, when we have recursion on the left side, it is like we are writing a recursive program, but in that recursive program, we are in, first of all, every time when we write a recursive program, first of all, we write the termination condition. But here in this case of this left recursive grammar, we are not writing any termination condition in the beginning. In the beginning, we are writing recursive program, and in the end, we are writing recursion. And that is why it is going to give you an infinite loop. Let me tell it to you with a simple example, very simple example. Assuming that we are having the following program. This is some function fun with integer n, and I am writing like this, fun of n minus 1. I am calling fun of n minus 1 every time, and in the next case I am writing if n is equal to 0, then return 0, right? You can say if n is 0 or if n is less than equal to 0, then return 0. Obviously, in this program, when we are giving this recursive call, now this, because this recursive call is the beginning, so this program will lead to an infinite loop. That means this program will run infinitely. But instead of this, if I could have written the same program like this, fun with integer n, if n is less than equal to 0, then return 0. Or then fun of n minus 1. Now if you consider this one, then you can see that here we are writing the termination condition in the beginning of the program, and then we are making this recursive call. Now these two programs here, this one can be shown at, if this is s, then this is s and this is some a, and here if this is s, this is a and this is s. That means this can also be shown as s can derive sa. And here it can also be shown as S can derive AS. Okay, so here, because we are checking the termination at the beginning, therefore that is why it is not going to an infinite loop. And here, because we are not checking any condition at the beginning, that is why it is going to take you an infinite loop. That is why most of the parsers, or can say most of the parsing algorithms, which whatever we are going to study here, if you give a left recursive grammar to those parsing algorithms, then they will create a problem because they will end up in an infinite loop. Okay, see, left recursive grammar create an infinite loop for top down parser, so we have to eliminate left recursion. So let me write it to you in a clear manner. Left recursive grammar create an infinite loop for top down parser. I'll tell you what is a top down one and bottom up parser. I've written this statement, these two left recursive, that is going to infinite loop with, for the top down parser only. So for top down parser, so we have to eliminate left recursion. We have to eliminate left recursion from this one. Okay, that is called as left recursive grammar. Okay, so that is a problem with the left recursive grammar. Now in the next video, we are going to see if I'll give you a grammar which is left recursive. Now, can you convert that left recursive grammar to a right recursive grammar? Okay.